Example 2, so a person of 1.6 meter height stands at 0.6 meter from a surface of a hanging shiny globe in a garden. So if the diameter of the globe is 18 centimeter, where is the image of the person relative to the surface of the globe, and how tall is the person's image that the characteristics of the person's image? So given is the height of the object, which is 1.6 meter, and also the distance from the mirror, so that is 0.6 meter. Okay, so all of this, the mirror, I mean the object, is in front of this mirror here, so that's why it is positive. Okay, and then so we have to calculate the image formula, image of the person relative to the surface of the globe. So this, if you look at here, this is a convex surface. So if it's a convex surface, the focal length will be negative lah. Okay, so the radius of curvature is gonna be negative divided by the diameter divided by 2 lah. So this would be negative 0.09 meter. All right, and then what else? Now we can apply the mirror's equation, which is 2 over r equal to 1 over u plus 1 over v. This is question A, yeah? And then you would get the image to be equal to negative 0.042 meter, which is behind the globe's surface, behind this surface lah. Okay, because why is it behind the surface? It's because this is a negative value. All right, so how tall is the person's image? We are going to use magnification punya formula, which is height of the image divided by height of the object equal to negative v over u. So from here we can then get the image object to be equal to 0.112 meter lah. All right, okay, so what is the characteristics of the person's image? Since it is formed behind the surface, it is visual. Okay, and then if you don't want to know based on the calculation just now, you just have to remember lah apa characteristics untuk convex punya mirror. Okay, so it will be upright and then diminish, and then lastly form behind the reflecting surface. Okay, so that are the characteristics untuk convex mirror. Okay, right, and that is on example number 2.